I'm here to tell you about a plan that will save the environment and the economy at the same time. My plan is not political or partisan, it's simply practical and achievable. Who am I? My name is Robert Houston, and I'm an artist and a citizen. I'm not a politician, I'm not a scientist, I'm not anybody with a stake in this thing at all. Oh, except seeing the economy recover, except seeing great jobs created, except seeing America once again be a global leader on the world stage, guiding the rest of the world into the future. As an artist, my job is to think of things that don't exist and bring them into being. Throughout history, artists have been called upon to help with the great problems of their day. In 1529, the artist Michelangelo protected the city of Florence from invasion by rebuilding the city's walls. During World War I, British artists saved thousands of lives by devising an ingenious scheme to paint ships in a way that made it hard for German submarines to see them. The economy is in shambles. On this, we can all agree. Why? Because not enough of us have jobs, and the jobs that many of us have are not good enough. Economies are built on energy, our modern economy most of all, and we have an energy crisis in this country. We don't produce enough energy. We don't produce enough clean energy. And many of the energy dollars we spend are being paid to entities outside the United States that are directly hostile to our country. We're effectively funding our enemies through our energy policy. Our energy system is draining the economy when it could be building it. My plan is to turn the entire country into a power plant. But not this kind. This kind of power plant. My plan is called the Home Energy Loan Program, or HELP for short. HELP will create thousands of jobs, jobs in every state, jobs across multiple income levels. HELP will restore America's manufacturing and technological supremacy and drive national security. The state of North Dakota has enjoyed one of the lowest unemployment rates during the economic downturn, and this is partially due to a unique bank, the Bank of North Dakota. This is a state-owned and state-run bank, the only one in the country. It was set up in 1919 with the mission of helping drive economic activity in the state through low-interest loans to farmers and small businesses. It allowed North Dakota to regain control of its economy, which had been co-opted by outside interests. It continues to protect the state to this day, as the results show. HELP will create just such a bank at the federal level, the National Energy Bank. This bank will provide low-interest loans for individual homes to be converted to renewable, self-produced power. Think of it. Every house in the country producing power. The entire country, one giant power plant. If the lines get knocked down in a storm, your community still has power because it is all being produced and consumed within your neighborhood. HELP would require that your home energy solution be at least 60% manufactured in the United States. This would mean that small companies would immediately begin manufacturing here because they would know there was a guaranteed market for their products. This means jobs, good jobs, engineering jobs in research and development, jobs in manufacturing, jobs in shipping, jobs in transportation, jobs, jobs, jobs. These companies would have to advertise locally because as a loan program, the homeowner is incentivized to buy the most cost-effective solution, both in terms of upfront cost and energy produced. They are paying for it after all. Remember, this is a loan program. It would encourage competition and let the market decide which solutions are best. Additionally, it would pump advertising dollars into local radio, print, and television ads, creating yet more local jobs. These companies would have to hire local installers and technicians, creating yet more local jobs. Energy jobs are the jobs of the future. HELP will jumpstart this industry here, and it will be driven by marketplace competition. But without a program such as HELP to create this market, we are leaving the development of tomorrow's technologies to other countries. And that means that all of the jobs, all of the revenue that will go with this development will go to other countries. HELP would work like this. You, as a consumer, go out in search of a company to put some sort of renewable system into your home. Now, this could be solar or wind or something that hasn't even been invented yet. You purchase the equipment from the company and get it installed, but the bill is paid directly from the National Energy Bank to the company. The money does not pass through your hands. You now begin paying a loan payment monthly to the bank. Remember, this is a loan program, not a handout. To qualify, your system would have to be grid-tied, and any additional energy your home produces would be purchased back into the grid by the local utility. This would be mandated by law. Many states already have this law on the books, and it was provided for in the Energy Policy Act of 2005, passed under the Bush administration. Utility companies would slowly begin to morph their business model from being power producers to being power managers and brokers. This will be a huge boon to utilities as they will no longer have to outlay cash for power plant construction, operation, or maintenance. To be sure, the large central power plants that we have today will be needed for the foreseeable future, but we won't have to build more. We all agree that power sources that don't produce waste in any form are better than those that do. The problem that has been holding back wind and solar so far has been transmission. That's because people have taken a new form of energy, a new technology, and tried to fit it into an old mold, the mold of large, centrally located coal and hydro plants. Coal and hydro plants have to be large and centrally located because they work on the efficiency of scale. But the beauty of wind and solar is that they are such great local sources of power. Think about the little strip at the top of your calculator. It produces power where it's needed. No transmission, no problem. The National Energy Bank would provide these loans at an incredibly low rate, 1 to 3%. The goal of the bank is not to produce profit, but rather to drive technological development in the private sector. The bank would produce income monthly, however, in the form of loan payments and interest. As an example, the Bank of North Dakota is profitable and has regularly returned money to the state of North Dakota, helping to protect the state during economic hard times. Homeowners would be encouraged to participate because they could actually eliminate their electrical bill by installing a system that returns as much or more to the grid as they use, canceling their bill entirely, or even generating a small return to them, all with no upfront cost to the homeowner. HELP will only be open to homeowners. However, businesses can also install systems at their own cost and enjoy the energy buyback program. Utilities would then redistribute the power from homes with systems to those without, as well as businesses and municipalities. This is exactly what utilities do now, regulate the grid, but they would not be saddled with the cost of production. Think there's not enough wind or sun in the United States to power this program? Germany is actually leading the world right now in solar energy production, not the sunniest place in the world, and it doesn't take a 30-mile-an-hour wind for wind turbines to work. But remember, HELP is not about what technology we have right now. It's about what we can create tomorrow. HELP will drive innovation and new technology through marketplace competition. The exact details of HELP could be structured in a variety of ways. The results are the important thing. The most important outcomes of this program are, 1. The instant incentive for companies to go into renewable energy design and manufacture in the United States due to the creation of a guaranteed market. 2. Jobs, jobs, jobs. Jobs that will be created not just in one place, but all across the country. 3. Clean and abundant energy to power our future. 4. National security. With power produced everywhere, we are safer from natural disaster, and with more abundant electricity, we can move toward electric vehicles and stop funding other parts of the world that are hostile to the United States. 5. A cleaner environment with lower emissions. Regardless of climate change, this program will make our air and water cleaner and make America a better place to live.